since I have not seen a video demo of anybody doing the golf cart battery setup on their tab, I thought I would do a quick one to show you how I did it. I'll start with the outside and then I'll take the lid off and show you the inside. This is a 2 battery box that I picked up online, and I will post the link in the comments where I purchased it because it was quite a bit cheaper than other places online that had the same exact box. Pretty happy with the construction of the box. It's solid and there are ample places to put ZAMP ports as well as other type of cables coming in and out. I strapped the whole thing down with a lockable ratchet strap, and there are 2 of these screw knobs that come out. And there's a rubber washer underneath. I'll show you in just a second. So maybe I won't, it's down in there. It's underneath, but you could sort of see. Anyway, they come off pretty easy, and if I have to get into it while I'm camping, not a problem. Show you how I have it mounted onto the trailer itself. There are 2 pieces of angle iron, one in the front, one in the back, and lots of big fender washers and bolts drilled directly into the frame. This seems to be pretty sturdy. I filed down the corners and spray painted it black to give it a more standard look. It's the heavier duty or angle that you pick up at either Home Depot or Lowe's, and it works pretty well. Pretty happy with it. And it's less obtrusive than some other methods I could have chosen. Come around to this side of the box so that you can see I have a Blue Seas battery cutoff switch mounted on the side, and you can also see the trailer wiring harness coming in through that little groove that's built into the battery box. So that's the exterior. Here's another ZAMP port going directly to the battery. I do have an extra one other than the one that came with the tab, and I fused it. So I was able to do this with a lot of help from folks in forum and Facebook, and I thought this would be a good way to give back so that other people who come after me can do the same thing. I went with 2 Trojan T105s, and I was able to get them locally in a place in Cranberry, PA, North Pittsburgh. They actually delivered them to my house, and I'll put a link to this battery dealer in the comments as well. So the 2 6 volts are connected together on the positive going to the negative of the 2 batteries. So these 2 posts are only used to connect the batteries together. That's what takes it from 2 separate 6 volts to 1 12 volt energy source. Next, I'll show you how I wired the switch. I have that coming off the negative cable. So again, we're only going to be working with 1 negative post and 1 positive post in this setup. Here's the negative, and this goes directly to the switch, and then the switch negative from the trailer harness goes to the other side of the switch. It's that simple. Nothing more complicated than that. These are Camco. This is a Camco battery cable. It's a tray cable, and I got it at Amazon. I'll put the link to that in the comments as well. Here you can see is 1 negative for a ZAMP, and here is another negative for a ZAMP. So all that going to the ZAMP ports for here and here. On the positive, we have a ZAMP, and we have a, see, I labeled these when I moved it. This is the ZAMP, and then this is the positive that goes to the trailer. So I know these can be scary, really not too complicated. Probably the most complicated thing I did was to add the fuse to the second ZAMP that I picked up, and I simply did that with a butt connector that you can get at the hardware stores. Very easy, you just slide the bare copper in each end and then crimp down with a crimping tool. And I stuck a fuse in the fuse holder. That was really as complicated as it got. So it's a quick walkthrough of my two battery setup. I hope this was helpful.